tradition as one of the proudest wrestling nations on the planet selects its representatives for the finals of the Pro Wrestling World Cup. Tonight, the great nation of Japan enters the competition. Dave Bradshaw here alongside James R. Kennedy. And James, what a night of action we're about to have.
It's going to be incredible. You can tell by the response of these people. They came here tonight to see professional wrestling and professional wrestling. Listen to that, Dave Bradshaw. Already, they know that WhatCulture Pro Wrestling is the place to get the best pro wrestling.
はい、皆さん、こんにちは。新日本プロレスの中心、サンダー・ライガーです。
田口隆介です。よろしくお願いします。
このワールドカップ、素晴らしい大会だと思います。日本のレスラーやアメリカ、イギリス、各国のレスラーが集まってナンバーワンを決めるという大会。この大会が2回、3回続くように祈ってますし、その大会に参加したいと思います。
そうですね、はい、まあ、私は田口ジャパンというチームを組んでますので、常に、日本代表は意識してますので、持ってこいの大会が開催されるということで、はい、精一杯頑張ります。
ミスター田口 He's a very strong, yeah, very clever, good technician. 田口っていう選手は素晴らしい選手だと思います。第1回戦で彼と当たります。楽しみにしています。
はい、そうですね、これトーナメントなんで、はい、まず一発目はですね、しっかり、ジュシンサンダーライガーの技をですね受けて、その上でライガーさんの上を行きたいと思います。
このままライガーどこまで行くか分かりません。ただこういう大会がある限り、ぜひ参加したいなと思っていますし、この大会が永遠にフォーバー続くぐらい
日本代表になれると思います。普段の力を出せるように頑張ります。世界最高のケツを見てください。
Our first match in the Pro Wrestling World Cup Japanese qualifier is coming up. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for Jushin Thunder Liger versus Taguchi.
What tail of the tape? It says you have two celebrating athletes going head to head. It's really tough to see who has the advantage in this one, Dave Bradshaw. You're going to have to wait and see.
I'm excited, it's going to be an incredible night. Let's take it up to our ring announcer and get things underway.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is scheduled for 1-4 and is a qualifying match for the first of the Japan leg of the Pro Wrestling World Cup. 皆さん、本日は時間無制限一本勝負を行います。最初は
I taught him that earlier on.
Introducing first,
what a way to start things out! What a best of all time, Jushin Thunder Liger!
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, hailing from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 95 kilos, he is Jushin Thunder Liger!
James R. Kennedy, listen to this ovation for one of the most iconic wrestlers in the history of the Japanese grapple game!
What a way to start this Japanese leg of the Pro Wrestling World Cup than was one of the greatest Japanese wrestlers on planet Earth today.
Introducing his opponent.
Jushin Thunder Liger in the first of four first round matches here in the Japanese leg of the Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifiers. Of our four winners here, all will go into the second round, and by the end of tonight's games, we will have two representatives advancing to the finals to represent Japan.
And the big question as always, exactly who will it be? People are expecting big things from Jushin Thunder Liger here. Can he deliver to his fans?
Very surreal situation here to see Jushin Thunder Liger in particular in front of us here in a packed out hall, the Bowlers Exhibition Hall in Manchester, England.
When you look around this venue and you see that people are starstruck by what they're seeing in front of them, and no wonder, these two men are ready to put on quite the showcase, and I can't wait to see it.
Well, when this Pro Wrestling World Cup was announced, it was said that some of the best in the world would come and participate, and that is certainly what has happened here. Not just with these two, but the other six you're going to see are six or eight of the finest from Japan.
Are we going to get four matches of this, Dave Bradshaw? Respect already? Come on.
Yeah, I know it's not something you're particularly familiar with, but...
Absolutely not. It has no place in professional wrestling. Winning is all that matters.
Taguchi going to back Liger into the corner, and they are going to get another clean break. Don't forget, by the way, if you want to comment on any of the action here, who you think is going to advance as the two representatives for Japan in the World Cup, give us your comments on social media using the hashtag Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Oh, wow, that's lovely, lovely stuff. Sweet transition right there.
Liger is going to try and roll backwards and increase the pressure on Taguchi.
What is it that moron King Ross would say? Lovely, lovely, lovely.
And it looks like Liger's going to be taken down by the head scissors from Taguchi. You've got an early two count there. Taguchi, known as the funky weapon over in New Japan Pro Wrestling.
I dread to think.
There's a drop toe hold, and Liger trying to counter, but eventually gets taken down.
Well, this crowd are split right down the middle. There's obvious adulation for both these athletes. It's very clear, crystal clear, in fact.
The Taguchi is as legendary as Liger is. Taguchi is very much a fan favourite as well. Likes to play to the crowd. Very happy-go-lucky personality you see from Taguchi. But don't be mistaken, he can go in the ring. As we're seeing here, he is holding his own against Liger.
There's a few people in this building that I met earlier on that I would describe as funky weapons. Let's see what Taguchi has to offer.
Taguchi, a two-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion, five-time Junior Heavyweight Tag Team Champion, among other things, in New Japan. I could start listing you the accomplishments of Jushin Thunder Liger, but we'd be here all week.
Well, Liger already unhappy with senior official Steve Linsky. It's going to be interesting to see how that story develops as this match goes on, because he's getting frustrated very early, if you ask my humble opinion.
Liger has been around the block many a time. He is a master not only of the physical game, as you're seeing here, as he stretches Taguchi out, but also the mental game. Such an innovator in the world of pro wrestling is Liger, the inventor, among other things, of the shooting star press.
Spectacular moves, spectacular outfit, spectacular career.
Well, yeah, we have ended up in the ropes here. Referee Steve Linsky asking for the clean break, gets it.
And here we go, this crowd now firmly behind Liger. That's interesting. A little earlier on, they were in the corner of the funky weapon too. And just right on cue, these fans split right down the middle again. What an atmosphere we have in here, Dave Bradshaw.
Side headlock by Liger. Taguchi trying to find a way out here. Liger will get sent to the rope. Shoulder block sends Taguchi off his feet. Liger gets hip tossed down. Another shoulder block. Taguchi just trying to work out a way to gain an advantage, and that's not the way, because he got backdropped hard out to the arena floor. Liger,
you can be a veteran all you like, but you hit that floor.
A running somersault dive off the apron from Jushin Thunder Liger.
You hit that floor and you hit it hard. And that's something Taguchi just found out firsthand right here in Manchester.
Liger rolling back into the ring, going to force his opponent here to answer the count of 10.
Well, this could be potentially be a long night for one of these men. It's very, very smart to pace yourself just as Liger is right now.
I was talking about that long list of accomplishments for Liger. But the one thing he hasn't got, of course, because there never has been one before, is a Pro Wrestling World Cup to his name. So how much would it mean to Liger, not only to be representing his country, but from his own personal point of view, to win this for Japan?
Well, that would just cap such a memorable career, and I'm sure he's super eager, not only to get by Taguchi here, but as you say, to win that Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Hang on, what's Liger doing here? Liger with a Hurricane Rana off the top. Taguchi may be out. The side press from Liger, and it's good for two.
And I hesitate to criticise a legend here, but if you notice, Liger failed to hook the leg there. If he had hooked the leg, maybe we would have been seeing him progress in this competition, but no.
Liger looking for maybe a powerbomb here. Taguchi, you see, is down on one knee trying to...
He's fighting it though.
...block here, and he's successfully done it. Great strength from that angle to get the backdrop. And he tried to drop down posterior first onto Liger, no one home. And Liger, this time he got him.
Funky weapon becomes a lethal one, I like it.
Taguchi starting to feel the energy here in Manchester. He'll go to the ropes again. Using those buttocks as a weapon here.
He's not wasting any time. You see the difference between these two men?
The cover here from Taguchi's got the leg hooked, and he was half a second away from advancing to the second round.
As I say, Liger was so eager to let Taguchi, to let him get counted out, but Taguchi, he's going straight for the jugular right here. I like it, I like this man's attitude.
Taguchi showing signs of that. His friend Shinsuke Nakamura, but instead the Tilton World backbreaker from Jushin Liger.
That may have cost him though, Bradshaw.
You see Liger here going for the surfboard perhaps. And he's got it. Taguchi with nowhere to go. No spare limbs to reach for the ropes. It's just a case of can he hold on for as long as Liger is able to keep his balance here? Or will Taguchi have to give up?
Oh,
he's down, his shoulders are down. Taguchi just was able to escape.
And
in
even
the nick
to
of
kick
time.
Out of that, Dave Bradshaw, even to kick out of that move right there must have been super painful for Taguchi. Human body's not designed to take that kind of punishment.
Liger, powerbomb, and a big one, right on the back of the neck of Taguchi, and it was very, very nearly enough.
The funky weapon staying in this, but Liger says he's about to finish it.
Liger with so many ways to finish an opponent, the brainbuster is his most notable one, that's maybe what he's going for here, but Taguchi goes behind. Liger gets his legs taken away. Taguchi will roll him up. He's got him all tied up. And he's got him! He's got him! Taguchi with an upset! Taguchi defeats Jushin Thunder Liger!
And you can see it on his face. Even Taguchi himself is surprised. Look at Liger. He's incredulous.
A real upset here as Taguchi advances at the expense of Jushin Thunder Liger. Taguchi is one win away from representing his country in next month's World Cup final.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Taguchi Ryusuke!
A crowd here with a mixed reaction, no disrespect to Taguchi, but so many Jushin Liger fans here. And this is a shock, a real shock.
You can feel the shock. You can see all the stunned faces around ringside. They were not expecting this, but right there, senior official Steve Linsky raises the hand. Taguchi advancing in the Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifier. What a great way to start this great event.
Liger is approaching Taguchi in the ring. There's a handshake and a fine show of respect. Again, something you don't... doesn't compute with you, but it certainly computes with these fine athletes from Japan.
If I was Liger, which I'm certainly not, obviously, but when the funky weapon turned his back, I would kick him real hard when he wasn't looking.
And that is why you are not, and never will be, Jushin Thunder Liger. Liger getting the respect of the crowd, but it is Taguchi who advances to the second round.
プロレスの小松です。今日はですね、 新日本プロレスのロス・インゴベルナーブルス・デ・ハポン高橋ヒロムです。
それもちろんですね、その日本の代表として来てるんで、まあこれ絶対負けられないですね。
正直のところですね、よく分かってないよ。このトーナメントに何の意味があるのか、何の価値があるのか何も分かんないけど、俺は出たからには優勝するよ。
まあ、もちろんその僕、まあメキシコだったりアメリカだったりいろんなところで試合してて、まあそのいろんな技術を吸収してるんで、それをぶつけるにはもう持ってこいの相手ですね。今の新日本プロレスのトップのレスラーなんで、もう食い下がって食い下がっても絶対勝っちゃいます。
作戦も何も大丈夫だよ、俺強いから。俺強いから普通にやって勝っちゃうもん。いやでも小松との試合はすごい楽しみだよ、ワクワクしてるよ。
どうやって勝利する、それは僕がですね、世界的なレスラーになるためのこうステップとして高橋ヒロムを使ってこの大会を制覇してやりたいと思ってます。
タイムボム、バーン、それ一発で。
Alright, let's roll on with the second match here in our Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifiers for Japan. Tailor the tape time between Hiromu Takahashi and Yohei Komatsu.
Well, Dave Bradshaw, yet again, James R. Kennedy is stunned by what we've already seen. Legends in the ring before us. These guys are looking to become legends.
Komatsu is watching backstage. He'll be as stunned as anyone that Jushin Thunder Liger is already out of this competition. Can he focus on this match? That's the burning question.
The Tempura Boys, am I right? The tag team, part of Komatsu, part of that tag team. This is one-on-one competition though, baby.
Takahashi, the more accomplished of these two young men, I think it's fair to say, a former IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. He's had success around the world as well. He was a World Lightweight Champion in CMLL, the oldest pro wrestling organization in Mexico.
He's
comes with an impressive resume, but one loss and you're out. You can have the impressive CV all you like. It's about getting the job done when that bell sounds, as it's just done. I'm going to sit back and enjoy this one with our new friend here on the announce desk.
Takahashi with the early advantage, countered by Komatsu. A little rake to the eyes. Takahashi, a part of the villainous Los Ingobernables, the ungovernables, literally, of Japan.
Easy for you to say.
I'm being corrected. Ingobernables. I can't, my accent is terrible. Anyway, here we go. Takahashi. Hurricanrana by Komatsu.
Let's not try a third time. Stiff straight. They're coming out of the traps flying here, Bradshaw.
Certainly are. It's been a fast-paced one from the start. That might slow Komatsu down. No, it won't, because he nips straight up. And Komatsu, more than happy to...
He's playing to the crowd here.
I don't think Takahashi realized he was up. And despite his underhanded ways, a large portion of this audience in Manchester supporting Takahashi.
Well, as I said before, Komatsu, it's going to be so, so intriguing. As a tag team specialist, the longer this match goes on, you have to believe that Takahashi is the firm favourite. But we'll see. We'll see.
Well, these two have only wrestled one previous time in singles competition. That was back in 2012. Takahashi was victorious on that occasion.
Even more of an incentive for Komatsu. And look at these two men.
Goodness me. The ferocity of this competition. Between these two, just chop after chop after chop. Look at the chest of both of these guys. It is red raw.
I thought that was going to go on all night, Dave Bradshaw. I must be honest.
Finally, Komatsu gaining the upper hand. He'll send Takahashi to the ropes. No, he won't. Reversal of the Irish whip. Ducks the clothesline, does Komatsu. Komatsu again ducks. And Komatsu with the leaping forearm hits Takahashi down.
The crowd now firmly behind Komatsu. They were behind Takahashi earlier on. What's going on here?
Winner of this one going to take on Taguchi in the second round after Taguchi upset Jushin Thunder Liger a few moments ago.
We've already seen what that man can do. It's going to be interesting. Do either one of these two men in the ring right now want to face Taguchi? That's the question.
What is that Komatsu doing here? He's got Takahashi tied up.
That's just insulting.
Big slap across the face.
I like it though. Disrespect 100%.
Komatsu showing a confidence beyond his years. He's only been wrestling for 4 years. He goes for another cover, gets a two. Was the Wrestling Observer Rookie of the Year back in 2013. He continues to put the boot in.
He's firmly on top. No doubt about it. You can see it with your own two eyes. Takahashi has to do something special to get back into this one. Otherwise, his dreams are shattered and he will be out of the Pro Wrestling World Cup. Unthinkable for either one of these young men.
Komatsu again going into the corner. Another big shot, just making that chest even more red.
Oh, blood red.
Takahashi goes into the... corner gets slides out. He's being pursued here by Komatsu.
Bit of a foot race
now,
going on.
Hang on a second. Takahashi! Oh my god! He tried to bring him down. Komatsu, half of his body weight landing on top of Takahashi, but Takahashi still got the best of that one.
I don't think he got all of it though, Dave Bradshaw. Believe me, I think if Komatsu had splatted right in front of us here at the announce desk, if his head had hit that concrete floor, we'd be waving goodbye to Komatsu here tonight. Takahashi maybe doesn't even know that. He maybe thinks that he got 100% of that move.
Well, Takahashi's cat here on our announce table looking on with concern, as this is a seesaw match between these two. And of course, by the luck of the draw, inevitably it means that their opponent, or whoever wins this, their opponent in the second round is getting more and more rested by the minute while these two continue to go at it.
Absolutely. You must think that Taguchi right now is sitting there with a cold glass of icy cool water, watching it in a monitor someplace, knowing that Takahashi and Komatsu, they've spilled out of the ring. This is getting increasingly violent. I must admit, I did not expect this after the respect we saw between Liger and Taguchi.
Takahashi goes for a cover, didn't hook the leg. Still good for two.
Both these men with so much to prove here tonight though, Dave Bradshaw.
Takahashi, another chop. How many of those can the human chest endure?
I think his chest just landed somewhere back over in Japan. That was thunderous.
Now look at this from Takahashi. We saw some confidence from Komatsu a little earlier on, and now we're seeing confidence bordering on cockiness from Takahashi. Takahashi put on the brakes. Komatsu went for the drop kick, but the ticking time bomb saw it coming.
He put his all into that one. Connected that time though.
First one from Komatsu, second time as well. Oh my, takes him down face first, goes Takahashi. Komatsu will go to the ropes. There's a shining wizard. And Komatsu, I think, believes that he is moments away from victory here.
Well, he may not be wrong, and it looks like this live crowd here in Manchester are right there with Komatsu.
Komatsu lining him up. Takahashi put his feet up. Big chop from Komatsu. Dangerous position here. Double knees into the abdomen.
That could be all she wrote.
Takahashi is going to go out here. No, he's not. He just escaped on two. Great competitive action here in the first round of the Japanese qualifiers.
Komatsu looks so confident right now. He has this match well in hand, and he's ready to end it all.
The pump handle here, what's he trying? Maybe trying to stretch out Takahashi, who escaped very quickly. An enziguri. Oh, Takahashi with the forearm. Komatsu into the ropes. Oh my, the rope just bouncing back into the face of Komatsu. Komatsu kicking into the face of Takahashi. There's a German suplex with the release right on the back of his head around Takahashi.
He's seeing stars. Don't kid yourself. That could be it. This could be the road to Komatsu advancing to face Taguchi in the next round.
Takahashi is badly shaken here. Very slow to his feet. Again, Komatsu lines him up. Komatsu will charge. Takahashi catches him, overhead belly to belly, right into the bottom turnbuckle.
And this is where what I talked about earlier on, Dave Bradshaw, comes into play. Komatsu, a tag team specialist. The longer this match goes on, you have to believe that Takahashi is the favourite. Who can get the second win here?
But again, sorry to harp on this, but whoever wins this, how much is going to be left of either of these guys? Maybe Taguchi will just be able to pick the bones of whoever's left here.
He'll be licking his chops as we speak.
Who would have thought as we started this night that at this point Taguchi would be one of the favourites to advance here. He is looking more and more in good shape to advance into the finals in this top half of the draw because of the competitive nature of this match. Takahashi tries to hold on. He can't do it. Komatsu's got his shoulders down, trying for the win. He'll go to the ropes again. Again,
go again.
Leaps over the top. Again got his shoulders down, but again it's only two. Rolling backwards. Komatsu trying to tie him up. This is how Taguchi won a few minutes ago, and it was very, very close to doing the same for Komatsu.
You ain't kidding. This is tremendous stuff.
Big super kick into the jaw from Takahashi. Komatsu fires back quickly with a clothesline. Gonna pick him up. Twisting neck breaker from the vertical suplex position. He'll go for the cover. Will it be enough? Oh, was it? No, no.
Look at the anguish on Komatsu's face. He, just like us, Dave Bradshaw, just like everyone here in Manchester, and probably even referee Joel Allen, believed that that was all finished.
Referee with a hell of a job on his hands here to keep up with the pace of this action. Both men trying to win with every fibre of their being here. Again went for the pump handle. This time Takahashi counters with a German suplex. Komatsu straight up. Look at the fire from Komatsu, but that'll knock him down. Cover. Takahashi may have knocked him out. And oh, no, he hasn't. Goodness me, what a match. What a match in the first round here.
You know, if I'm Jushin Thunder Liger right now, I'm pleased I'm not still in this competition. Not with these two young men. They're tearing one another apart.
Oh, good. That's the time bomb! The time bomb from Takahashi! And the ticking time bomb advances into the second round to face Taguchi! What a match! Wow!
Stunning stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Takahashi Hiromu!
They are on their feet in the Bowlers Exhibition Centre in Manchester.
as two of the finest in Japan have shown what that great wrestling country is all about. But right now, Takahashi doesn't have time to celebrate. He's got to focus on his upcoming second round match.
What is this?
This is sinister right here is what this is.
A strange young man is Takahashi, but a very, very talented one.
Well, he's going to come back for his little friend. Here we go.
He's one win away now from being back here in England for the finals of the 2017 World Cup.
How come that toy, and I'm going to call it like it is, how come that toy got a bigger reaction than me?
For many, many reasons. Anyway, Takahashi advances to face Taguchi in the second round.
Hello, England. My name is Tiger. Tiger Mask desu. Shin Nihon Pro Wrestling Tiger Mask desu. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu.
Los Ingobernables Japón, Bush.
そうですね。僕はイギリスに来るのは20年ぶりぐらいになるんでね。もう20年前の同じようなね、ファイトで、そして日本と同じファイトで、このトーナメント勝ち進んでいきたいなと思います。
まあ決まったカードだからやるだけ。
そうですね。まあ武士はね、今日本でも結構ね、ずるい、ね、スニーキーなことをするんでね、ちょっとそれに注意しながら、あとは彼はマスクをね狙ってくるんでね、その辺注意しながら試合をしていきたいなと思ってます。
作戦、まあスーパージュニアで勝ってるんでね、余裕でしょう。
そうですね。自分はね、キックとかね、サブミッションが得意なんでね、それを、出しながら、なおかつ日本とね同じようなファイトをして、必ずこのトーナメントを勝ち上がりたいと思ってます。
いや、もう自分のスタイルで勝つだけだよね。
うん、
それだけじゃないですか。勝つなら勝ち、何が何でも手を抜いて、エンセリオ、まあ、チーで。
Time for the third first round match in the Japanese qualifiers, the tail of the tape between Tiger Mask and Bushi.
You know, I've heard a lot about this man Tiger Mask over the years.Pro wrestling. It's going to be interesting to see him up close and personal. We've already seen one legend. Now we're about to see another. How can Bushi deal with Tiger Mask?
Junior heavyweight, IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion, which he both won and lost against Kushida, by the way, another man who's in this tournament.
Listen to this reaction. No wonder. Legendary status right here. What an opportunity for Bushi in this one, I have to say.
Well, we've already seen one legend in Jushin Thunder Liger. Here comes another. An honor to be in the presence of the fourth man to wear the Tiger Mask.
Making his way to the ring, hanging from Tokyo, weighing in at 83 kilos, Tokyo Shushin, 83 kilos.
Fourth person to wear the world famous Tiger Mask of the Bush is going to behind here.
What a way to make an impact from Bushi.
Bushi, no scruples whatsoever when it comes to doing what he needs to do.
Not standing on ceremony tonight. He wants to be one of those men to advance to the finals of the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Use it as a chair.
I did not expect this, Dave Bradshaw.
Bushi, obviously referee would be within his rights to disqualify him right there, but he's going to show some leniency as our senior official, Steve Linsky.
Steve Linsky knows what's at stake here. This is a very, very prestigious, did you like that word? Very, very important night, shall we say, in pro wrestling. And he's going to relax the rules just slightly. There he is, right in Bushi's face. And this crowd, all over Bushi. They do not like this, Dave Bradshaw, but you have to make a statement. He wants to get through to that next round. And I have to say, I'm impressed by what I'm seeing right now.
Well, talking of making a statement, this is kind of deja vu from the last time these two competed. These two have competed three times in the past. Tiger Mask won the first two. Bushi won the most recent one. But he had to use a steel chair to help him out, just as he has already used here.
Well, I shouldn't be surprised that you've just fed me that knowledge, because you see how Bushi came right out of the traps, attacking before Tiger Mask had even properly got himself into the ring. And look at this.
These two know each other very, very well, of course, as more as partners than opponents. They are former tag team partners.
There's a lot of history between these two men, obviously. You can feel it.
Bushi goes for an early cover. It's a two. Mention that this is the fourth Tiger Mask. He is the longest of the four to wear the mask. Been wearing it since 1995. Was trained by the original Tiger Mask, who of course had that legendary rivalry with the Dynamite Kid Tom Billington back in the 1980s.
So in effect, the torch was passed to him and he's ran with it.
What is this? Bushi is trying to remove that mask. That is the ultimate disrespect. Listen to this crowd.
It's almost sacrilege. Tiger Mask cannot let this happen, trust me. Humiliation awaits if Bushi has his way.
What is it? Come on, you can't do that. Show some respect.
I don't know how far Steve Linsky, senior official Steve Linsky, is going to relax these rules. But Bushi, he's pushing it. Yeah. He's pushing the envelope here tonight in Manchester.
Yeah, he's bending those rules. It can't be too much of a break.
I'll be surprised if Tiger Mask's ribs weren't broken after Bushi's assault with that steel chair.
Oh, big kick from Tiger Mask, and Bushi wisely perhaps rolls to the outside to try and regain himself, but Tiger Mask not going to give him any time. He's going to leap over the top onto him. Bushi moves out of the way.
You can tell that Bushi does not want to let Tiger Mask get going here. He wants to shut him down before he even has the chance. Perhaps he watched what happened earlier on when Taguchi defeated Jushin Thunder Liger. Bushi wants to make his own impact here at the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Winner of this one going to face the winner of our fourth and final first round match between Kushida and Sho Tanaka. There's Bushi back in.
Stunned here, Dave Bradshaw, by what we saw. I think they were expecting a night of respect, and Bushi gave them something completely different.
He might be about to surprise them all with a big win over Tiger Mask, but the veteran gets out of two. An STF here from Bushi.
Might not like his methods, but you cannot deny that the aggression is impressive.
Bushi is cinching down here. Tiger Mask having to exert a lot of energy.
He's going for that mask again, Dave Bradshaw.
Ripping and tearing at it while referee can't see, and Tiger Mask finally gets to the ropes. Bushi, as you might expect, going to use as much of that count of five as he can before he makes the break.
Well, again, he's pushing it to the limit. Steve Linsky surely won't put up with much more of this one.
Again, Tiger Mask having his mask ripped at by Bushi.
The live crowd don't want to see this. They have great respect for Tiger Mask. It's crystal clear. They do not want to see him humiliated here tonight.
Bushi is on the second turnbuckle. He'll go for a drop kick. No one home. That mask has been loosened, and the danger here for Tiger Mask clearly is if it switches position here, it could affect his vision. He's kicking the back of the thighs of Bushi. And Tiger Mask. A double underhook. Sit-out powerbomb. He'll go for the cover. Referee down, and it's 2.5.
That was picture perfect right there from Tiger Mask. as you say, that mask loosened and the vision could come into this. I think that's what Bushi wanted to do right from the off. He wanted to unsettle Tiger Mask, not let him wrestle.
Yeah, hang on, what's this from Tiger Mask? Tombstone pile driver!
Wow.
The head of Bushi bouncing off the canvas like a tennis ball.
He's ready to fly.
Tiger Mask, maybe we're going to see that trademark diving headbutt. We do, but no one there as Bushi moves out of the way. Both men have come off the top now. Both men finding nobody home. And both men are down.
Calculated stuff from Tiger Mask. He 100% was sure that he was going to connect with that headbutt. But Bushi, right at the last split second, moves out of the way. And Tiger Mask, he splatted hard.
Referee Steve Linsky, it's up to a count of six. Both men stirring. I don't think we're going to have a double count out here. It's
too much at stake.
Bushi now wrenching that left arm and now the right arm as well of Tiger Mask backwards. Tiger Mask trying to get to his feet to relieve some of the pressure. He does so. And Bushi, that's one way out.
That's the experience edge of Tiger Mask right there.
Oh, Bushi! Overhead kick into the back of the cranium of Tiger Mask. Tiger Mask will come up though. He's going to catch him.
This is dangerous.
Bushi in a bad place. He's trying to fight Tiger Mask off.
They're right above us here, Dave Bradshaw.
Oh God, what is this? Tiger Mask slapping Bushi. No way! The double underhook. He's hooked. He's got that butcher's hook grip on Bushi.
No way!
Oh! Overhead suplex from the double underhook off the top. The cover from Tiger Mask, and it. What? Oh, Bushi caught the hand of the ref.
Ingenious. Nobody saw that one coming. Least of all Tiger Mask. Unbelievable stuff here.
It's unorthodox, but it's certainly clever from Bushi.
Oh, he was done for if he didn't grab the arm of Steve Linsky right there and then.
He may be done for anyway, because how much is that taken out of him? That suplex off the top, maybe going to go for the Tiger suplex. His trademark move, Tiger Mask, but Bushi backs him into the corner, had that one scouted. Bushi backslide, shoulders down, going to arch over the top. Look at this from Bushi, and that was very, very close to being enough for the victory.
Oh.
Referee Linsky being pushed, and Linsky is being pushed figuratively just about as far as he can be by Bushi here.
Oh,
go for the mask again. Bushi is going for Tiger Mask again.
He was so... Oh.
A low blow, come on. What
was
that?
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Bushi! Long blower off the top.
That's got cover. A jet.
And Bushi advances after the low blow on Tiger Mask.
Well, his tactics work for him, Dave Bradshaw. Absolutely work for him here tonight. He's the one who advances in the Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifier.
There, in dubious circumstances. Bushi with his hand raised. Listen to the cheers here in Manchester.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're all here, Bushi!
Well, you might not like the way he got there, but get there he did. Bushi advancing into the second round. One more victory tonight here in Manchester. And Japan will have the dubious honour of having Bushi as one of the men representing it in those World Cup finals. I'm not sure what Japanese fans around the world must be thinking about that. I'm not sure Tiger Mask must be thinking. He's been robbed here. But nonetheless, it is Bushi who advances in the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Tempura Boys のショーです。新日本プロレスの Kushida です。イギリス・マンチェスターにやってきました。今日は防衛戦はないですけれども、トーナメント絶対勝ちたいと思います。
まあそうですね、まあ、天ぷらも日本を代表する食べ物ですし、まあ、俺たちも日本を代表するレスラーなのかなという感じで、まあ、トーナメントまずは日本代表を勝ち取るためにね、負けてらんないです。
そうですね、今僕の腰には This is IWGP This is ROH TV タイトル2本のベルトがありますんで、
絶対に負けれません。
まあそうですね、まあ初っ端からチャンピオンが来るってことはまあ俺的にはありがたいですね。強いやつがやりたかったので、まあ俺も最近 MMA の試合も控えてるし、そういうサブミッションも打撃もすごい練習してるんで、まあそういう櫛田さんとやるのはすごい楽しみだったので、じゃあ自分が今どれだけレベルが上がってるのか久しぶりに櫛田さんとシングルで確かめたいです。
いや、He is very young、すごく若いので、インサイドワーク、I use インサイドワークAnd brain、を使ってテクニックを使って勝ちたいと思います。
最後はまあプロレスなので、ね、最後はまあ気持ち、技とか力とかいうのも最後は気持ちになってくるんで、まあやられてもやられても最後に勝ってればいいかなという感じですね。
ベストオブスーパージュニア、今年優勝しましたんで、この盛り上がりを世界に広げていく意味でイギリスでこのワールドカップを成功させたいと思います。そのためには櫛田が優勝するしかありません。
Time for the tail of the tape in our final first round match in these Japanese qualifiers. Qushida going to go up against Sho Tanaka. And James, these two have competed on four previous occasions. Qushida has won all of them.
Well, that's a bit of a landslide. But we just saw some questionable tactics, I think you said, from Bushi against Tiger Mask. Qushida and Sho Tanaka, they may have to follow suit here tonight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, before this next match, a little bit extra for you. The referee for this match has been refereeing over 30 years. He's come over from Japan, from New Japan itself. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Taiga Hattori!
Tanaka.
Well, Sho Tanaka needs better luck than Komatsu had. They can't go home, these Tempura boys, empty-handed because of the Shota.
If not already, one of the greatest pro wrestlers on the planet Earth today, but
Sho Tanaka has the chance to make his own splash here at the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
See that championship gold, he's raising above his head. Titles from both Ring of Honor and New Japan. New Japan, he is in his fifth reign as the IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. Also had tag team success alongside Alex Shelley as part of the Time Splitters.
But we didn't see Honor in that last match between Bushi and Tiger Mask.
Well, we did from Tiger Mask.
Well, I'll give you that, we did. But Bushi, he's the one who got his hand raised. Who's it going to be between Kushida and Sho Tanaka right here?
Tanaka. No slouch, even though, as we say, Kushida has won every previous meeting between these two. He's been wrestling since high school, has Sho Tanaka, specializes in Greco-Roman style. Chose to become a professional wrestler after being inspired by New Japan legend Hiroshi Tanahashi.
Well, if you're going to take inspiration, why not take it from the best?
Kushida trying to take off his balance here. Tanaka does so, finally takes him down, straight back to his feet, headlock takedown, head scissors from Tanaka, and we're back up.
They're just feeling each other out, one another out here, Dave Bradshaw, the test of strength, and now these leg scissors. One man is trying to get the upper hand over the other. The crowd, they want it to be Kushida.
Well, Kushida has had such a great year already in 2017, as we've already talked about. Best of the Super Juniors for the second time.
It's so much more memorable if he could get to the finals of the Pro Wrestling World Cup, believe me.
Big leapfrog, and Kushida gets caught by Tanaka. Look at the strength. Look at the counter. The sunset flip from Kushida, and it's good for two. Tanaka, I think he's raking the eyes there, is he? Referee, one of the most experienced professional wrestling referees on the planet.
Oh, God! Out of nowhere.
From Kushida.
Even Kushida looks surprised. Not as surprised as Tanaka, though.
Kushida is on the apron. And a seated senton.
Wow.
Takes out Tanaka. Kushida, so impressive in the pro wrestling world. Interesting that he had options, he chose a pro wrestling career, had a very successful, blooming career in MMA. Chose to focus his talents on pro wrestling, much to our benefit.
Well, a very dangerous man for a multitude of reasons then. You can see it. Look at that, the way he has grabbed that arm, and he ain't letting Tanaka's arm free.
Trying to wrench that elbow out of its socket, you see Tanaka rolling backwards. He's countered by getting the shoulders down. No, he hasn't. Look at that power from Sho Tanaka. Wow.
Stunning. Stunning strength. To be in that much pain, but have that much composure. Wow.
Tanaka and Komatsu, the Tempura boys, have been on an excursion in recent times away from New Japan. It's kind of a rite of passage when you're training to become a great in Japanese wrestling. They've been spending time in Ring of Honor, in CMLL in Mexico as well.
And now they're here in WhatCulture Pro Wrestling, right here in Manchester for the Pro Wrestling World Cup. And what an experience for Tanaka going up against Kushida here. This is what he wanted.
But here's a question for you. Komatsu's already out. What if Tanaka was to qualify as one of the Japanese representatives and his tag partner didn't? That would be something of an awkward dynamic within that team.
I think there might be some friction because, believe me, Tanaka, when Komatsu came back through that curtain after losing to Takahashi, Tanaka would have had to console him. His own tag team partner knocked out of the Pro Wrestling World Cup, yet he has the chance to make history and advance. Now, I wonder if Komatsu wished him the best of luck, or if there was some, as I say, friction between the Tempura boys.
And Tanaka has been taking a page out of the book of Bushi. He's been stretching the rules here. You just saw him choking Kushida for four of a possible five count. Referee, again, letting him bend the rules but not break them, as he's going to pick him up from the fisherman suplex. Great stuff from Tanaka, and it was nearly enough. The arm bar.
He's capitalizing quickly.
Roll through again, just trying to surprise Kushida by
by changing his angles all the time. Look at him wrenching back on that left arm.
Well, as you say, Tanaka inspired to become a pro wrestler by Hiroshi Tanahashi. Well, he was inspired by Bushi's actions earlier on tonight. He has taken this fight to Kushida.
Tanaka, I think, with an extra incentive here, given, as I said, he's never beaten Kushida one-on-one. And Tanaka, I believe, increasingly, as he's honing his craft around the world, that his time is coming. And a win against Kushida, given the year Kushida is having, would be a real career highlight for this young man, Tanaka.
Well, no. What a statement it would be for Tanaka to defeat Kushida here. Best of the Super Juniors. You kidding? You have the chance to get to advance in the Pro Wrestling World Cup and beat that man? Special.
Tanaka's going to send Kushida to the ropes. Knee into the face for his troubles. Both men retreating to their corners. Oh no! Look at that. Kushida sends Tanaka face first into the middle turnbuckle. Highly competitive back and forth match here. Let us know, by the way, who you think is going to win not only this match, but our second round matches as well. As ever, the hashtag Pro Wrestling World Cup.
All those people need to get on their Twitter machines and let the world know that the Pro Wrestling World Cup is something else.
Kushida with the running back elbow, trying to build up a head of steam here against Tanaka. Big hip toss, the handstand and the drop kick into the side of the head.
We've seen qualifiers from Mexico, Scotland, England and elsewhere. But you get the feeling that this Japanese Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifier was the one so many people were waiting on. I can see why.
Kushida with high knees into the jaw of Tanaka. Tanaka reverses the Irish whip. He's going to get into the corner. Kushida gets the boot up onto the second turnbuckle. Kushida of the tornado DDT rolls through and into an armbar. In fact, it's a Kimura. Go for the Kimura lock. And, well, Tanaka absolutely frantic in getting to that bottom rope, because if you know a Kimura lock, you know it can snap an arm in just a second.
Well, we certainly don't want anyone to get carried out of here with a broken arm, but such is competition. It's fierce right here tonight.
Kushida trying to work on that arm, and instead Tanaka catching him in a sleeper hold. Obviously we're in the rope, so he's going to have to break. But once again, Tanaka using all of that five count.
Had Tanaka locked that in the centre of the ring, we could have been kissing goodnight to Kushida.
Even so, it was enough to slow Kushida down. He's looking groggy.
Absolutely.
Here. Kushida trying to counter what looks like an attempt to suplex him to the outside. That's dangerous stuff from Tanaka. They both ended up on the apron.
One wrong move and your evening is over, guys.
Especially from here.
Dangerous stuff on that ring apron.
Not the place you want to be. Especially if someone's kicking you in the head. Kushida gets his leg caught by Tanaka.
Oh, what is this now?
Tanaka, not a pile driver, surely not. He's going for a pile driver.
Could end the man's career.
Hard corner of the ring. And Kushida uses all his strength to pick up Tanaka. Tanaka's on his feet. So kick to the head. Leg sweep from Tanaka. Smart stuff from this youngster. And a drop kick into the back. Sends Kushida to the outside. Tanaka starting to feel it here in Manchester.
Tanaka feels he has momentum here. It's hard to argue with that. Oh, here we go.
Primal growl from Tanaka. He's lifting Kushida like dead weight. Maybe going for the German suplex. Kushida will fight his way out. And Kushida, again with the Kimura. Variation on it.
He could have snapped the arm of Tanaka right there.
Yeah, but look, Tanaka has got his fingers hooked from his other arm, his spare arm, his right arm. That is the only thing keeping Kushida off. But now Kushida applying his whole body weight. He has separated the arms.
Oh, that bone could break right before our very eyes.
Look at this. Tanaka's eyes are rolling into the back of his head, using every ounce of strength, every ounce of energy he has left. But there's plenty left. Look at this. From Tanaka.
Down across the knee. He's got the
gut buster in the end. Rolls him up. And oh, my goodness. Very, very close. 2¾ for Sho Tanaka.
What a battle between these two men. This just shows you how much the Pro Wrestling World Cup means to the great nation of Japan.
Much like Komatsu, his tag partner before him, Sho Tanaka, extremely impressive. He's going to go for that package pile driver, his finishing move. And Kushida will counter. Kushida forearm to the face out of desperation more than anything else from the best of the Super Juniors. But look at that slap. The echo around the building. Kushida, oh my.
Wow, that was like a gunshot.
Kick right into the thoracic section of the spine. It's a Pele kick.
Well, you might win the World Cup of Soccer with that one.
Kushida.
Let's see if he wins the World Cup of Wrestling.
Tanaka catches him into the German suplex with the bridge to win. Oh no! And Kimura! Nowhere to go for Tanaka! Nowhere to go for Tanaka! He's in the middle of the ring! Kushida!
Can he get to those ropes?
Well, Tanaka in a slightly better position now. Kushida had his whole body weight on top of him. Wait, what's this? Throws him through. Oh, caught him! He caught him! Kushida catches him with the back to the future! And Kushida advances to the second round of the Japanese qualifiers! Another spectacular match here in the Bowlers Exhibition Center!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Kushida!
Kushida showing why he is regarded as one of the hottest wrestling talents in the world right now, as he moves on to the second round where he will face Bushi.
What a match that's going to be. You saw the tactics from Bushi earlier on tonight. Kushida getting his way with Sho Tanaka, both the Tempura boys. They're gone. Bye bye. They're out of the Pro Wrestling World Cup. The competition here is magnificent.
Well, we started the night with 8. We are down to 4. By the end, we will be down to 2. Which 2 individuals will advance to represent Japan?
Ladies and gentlemen, all 4 winners will be proceeding to the final 2 final matches. 皆さん, この勝利者は全てファイナル2の試合に進みます。
Our ring announcer confirming that our 4 winners go on to face each other in the second round. Kushida advances at the expense of Sho Tanaka.
This is your WCPW General Manager, and I'm here to announce the official brackets for the US qualifier of the Pro Wrestling World Cup 2017. On the left side of the bracket, it's High Flyer against High Flyer as tag team partners face off, with Ricochet taking on Matt Sydal. Next up, the cowboy James Storm faces off against a professional mind blower, Keith Lee. The winners of those 2 matches will battle to determine the first competitor advancing to the finals in August. Over on the right side of the bracket now, we start with the best first-generation wrestler in the world, Jay Lethal, facing off against Moose. Finally, your favorite wrestler's favorite wrestler, David Starr, versus the one and only Bobby Fish. The winners of those matches will then fight to determine our second finalist. Tickets to see these phenomenal matches live on Friday, 21st of July in Manchester are available now at ProWrestlingWorldCup.com.
The first of our second round matches in the Japanese qualifiers pits Hiromu Takahashi against Ryusuke Taguchi. Taguchi was not expected to make the second round, James, but of course he has had longer to rest, and that advantage could be key.
It could pay dividends. But of course, Takahashi, he came through such a war against Komatsu. This is going to be another one. It's going to be incredible. I can't wait to see what happens.
From the World Cup Finals.
He could be about to make history after defeating Jushin Thunder Liger tonight. Second match against this man.
Takahashi in arguably the best match of the first round, an incredible hard-fought win against Yohei Komatsu. But how much has that taken out of Takahashi, especially given that his match took place after Taguchi's? Taguchi has had longer to rest. I just wonder whether this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity here for Taguchi to make the final.
Well, you hit the nail on the head. Taguchi had longer to rest. He could sit there and watch Takahashi against Komatsu. And are we going to get his little friend again here on the announce desk?
The only friend you've ever had, so I hope for your sake you do. Here he is.
See.
All right. Hiromu Takahashi. Ticking time bomb.
Do you think this thing is sentient?
What?
I'm starting to have my doubts. The connection that Takahashi has, I called it a toy earlier on this evening. I'm not convinced anymore. It seems to have a hold, a power over this man.
So you think there's like an Undertaker urn thing going on?
Well, you said it. Taguchi covering his ears here. Not fond of these chants.
Now, this is surprising, actually, because Takahashi, known for a little bit being a little bit more underhanded than Taguchi, so you would expect the crowd to be on Taguchi's side. But I think a portion of this crowd still haven't forgiven Taguchi for beating their hero Jushin Thunder Liger.
Well, that could be it. I don't think anyone expected Taguchi to be this far. Oh wow, it's a full moon.
Oh God, getting intimate here in Manchester.
I thought it was still light outside here. What is going on? It's a full moon here in Manchester.
But Taguchi needs to pull his tights up.
He's not doing it.
Well ventilated. Oh, God.
Maybe he thinks we're in Dublin. He just came here for the crack.
Taguchi.
Oh.
Holding onto the ropes and that.
Oh, God.
Some of our front row getting more of a close-up than they'd hoped for, I think.
Well, I don't know about you. I thought we were going to see all sorts of great technical wrestling, maybe even some brawling. I did not think that we would see spanking here at the Pro Wrestling World Cup qualifiers.
Well, it is the funkiest of weapons, and he is using it to his advantage, is Taguchi.
Well, thank God it was the back of his tights that fell down. Otherwise, we may have seen a different kind of weapon.
Ankle lock attempt there by Taguchi. Takahashi quickly into the ropes.
Smart move.
Again, the winner of this match and the winner of our next match between Kushida and Bushi will both advance into the finals of the Pro Wrestling World Cup, where they will represent Japan. So which two men do you think from these two matches will go on to represent Japan? Let us know on social media using the hashtag Pro Wrestling World Cup. Takahashi once again just taking his time, trying to slow things down after Taguchi was getting a little bit over-exuberant in the past couple of minutes,
so to speak. And look at this, scrambling. He's going for those legs of Takahashi.
Taguchi going behind. He's again trying for the ankle lock, and Takahashi knows that he had to get away there.
Just escaping. Taguchi, if he had got hold of one of Takahashi's legs there, Lord knows what he had in mind, but it wouldn't have been good. Not for Takahashi, anyway. It'd be very good for Taguchi. He could be going to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals.
Winner of this match will become the 11th man to qualify for that 16-man finals tournament. We already have two representatives from England, from Scotland, from Mexico, from Canada, and from Germany. Still qualifiers to come from the USA and the rest of the world.
Referee up to six.
Takahashi is taking his time here. He's going to use as much of this 10 count as he wants to. Taguchi quickly attacking Takahashi as soon as he got back in. And you can see, I think, some of what we were talking about here. The fact that Takahashi chose to get a breather out there, yep, suggests that he is more fatigued than his opponent.
100%. He needed that breather. As you said earlier on, he wrestled after Taguchi. Taguchi could sit there and watch as Takahashi, so he fought a hard-fought match to get to where he is right now.
Takahashi's in trouble.
Again trying for the ankle lock. Taguchi is absolutely determined.
Oh,
to hit that ankle lock, and Takahashi running away here. Or is he? Hang on a second.
He's going for that again. We saw it earlier on tonight.
Yeah, tried it against Komatsu. Oh. Once again, we are seeing more of Taguchi than we wanted to. And powerbomb into the ring apron on Taguchi.
Well, those trunks, those tights, the least of Taguchi's worries right now after that vicious powerbomb right on one of the hardest parts of a wrestling ring, the ring apron.
Again, though, look right in front of us here. Takahashi is trying to get some breath back. He's conversing with that cat.
I'm telling you, there's something in this. Do you think that holds the spirit of his grandmother or what? What's going on here?
Well, Takahashi is... picked up Taguchi here. Whatever his unorthodox tactics when he's over here with this cat, he's certainly not giving any chance for Taguchi to get himself back together.
Referees counting once more. What happens if both these men are counted out? That's a question that must be asked.
Takahashi just gave a kind of a wry look to the official there. Got Taguchi tripped over a wire and then ended up face first in the crowd barrier.
The first match of tonight, Dave Bradshaw, Taguchi versus Jushin Thunder Liger, pretty much exclusively took place between the ropes. Takahashi, he was one of the first to take it outside and brawl a little here at the Pro Wrestling World Cup, the Japanese qualifiers, and he's doing so yet again.
That's what I mean when I'm talking about that look he gave the official. What I'm saying is Joel Allen was starting a count, and Takahashi gave him a look as if to say, you're not going to count us out. You're going to let there be a winner in the ring. We know that. You know that.
Too much at stake here tonight. Oh.
Takahashi just chopping away here at Taguchi.
Only two men can go through to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals, and Takahashi, he wants to be one of them.
Said earlier he's had titles not only in New Japan but in CMLL and Mexico as well. So already an international pedigree for Takahashi, but would be the most prestigious of all the international titles he could win if he wins the Pro Wrestling World Cup. Don't forget, if you want to join us, by the way, at that last 16, the finals of the Pro Wrestling World Cup taking place between the 23rd and 26th of August in Milton Keynes, Manchester and Newcastle, you can get tickets right now at prowrestlingworldcup.com.
Exactly which one of these men will be in those finals, Dave Bradshaw?
Again, trying to use his backside as a weapon there with Taguchi. Takahashi this time wise to it. And Takahashi, gonna charge in, eats the boot of Taguchi. Again trying for the same kind of move, and Taguchi, I think, has gone there too often now.
He certainly has, and he's going to be walking funny tomorrow afternoon.
Takahashi, that time he did nail it.
So many Takahashi after that one, though.
He might be having nightmares after that. The funky weapon into the face of Takahashi. And this time into the chest, Taguchi. Feeling, if you listen to this crowd, split down the middle.
Well, they have been all night.
Here we go, Shining Wizard from Taguchi. Can he get a second win here?
Perhaps the only man who has really not got these people on his side, if you will, is Bushi. But these people seem to love all these athletes, and who can blame them? Taguchi. Oh. And he's looking for more funky weapon goodness.
What is he doing? Taguchi upside down, lured Takahashi in. Takahashi went for the drop kick, no one there. And now Taguchi going to go for that ankle lock again. This time he's got it. Twisting the ankle of Takahashi.
He's been trying to get that all match.
Try for the enziguri to Takahashi to escape. Taguchi ducked, the ankle lock still applied. We're in the middle of the ring here. Finally separates. Again takes out the leg. This time going to maybe try for the pin. Got him all wrapped up as Taguchi. His shoulders are down. Is it good? No, it's not.
That was almost it.
Very, very
Trust
close.
Me. That was so close.
Oh, my.
Oh, exploding. Exploding. And Taguchi, he hit those turnbuckles hard. And not only that, but the back of his head connected with that canvas.
Yeah. Huge, huge impact there. And exploding is right. What an overhead throw from Takahashi to really turn things around here against Taguchi.
There's light at the end of the tunnel for both these men, but only one. I'm going to say it again, I'm going to keep on saying it, because it's so, so important. Only one of these men, one, can get to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals. Who's it going to be?
It is hanging in the balance here. Takahashi, first to his feet. Taguchi, eyes glazed over. Takahashi senses that he can pick up the win here. Maybe he's going to go for the time bomb.
Been successful for him already this evening.
And looks like that was what he was going for. In any case, it didn't work. And ends up clotheslining Taguchi in the corner.
They're over in the other corner now. They're all over this ring. And not only that, they've spilled outside of it. Thankfully, they're back between those ropes.
Takahashi. Maybe going for a Rana, or is he? Oh, right. It'll collapse, whatever
he's
it was.
Ankle.
Whatever it was, it didn't go right for Takahashi. Both men falling to the ground awkwardly, but it's ended up with an ankle lock from Taguchi on Takahashi.
It's worked out for Taguchi, but look at this. Takahashi, he knew that was desperation. He had to get to those ropes. Absolutely had to.
You see, whenever Taguchi has tried to apply that ankle lock, the urgency from Takahashi has increased tenfold. He clearly fears that ankle lock more than any other move that Taguchi has.
Well, you saw him earlier on in this match, scrambling away from Taguchi outside the ring. He knows what this man, funky weapon name or not, is capable of.
Some fans again trying to support Takahashi here. Taguchi locking the arm back with Takahashi, finds a way to escape, ducks the clothesline. There's a German suplex from Takahashi.
Sheer competition. Pure athleticism.
Maybe, oh, takes him down.
That could be it.
Look
that
at that
be it.
From Taguchi. The cover to go to the World Cup Finals, and he was a split second away.
That was his moment, Dave Bradshaw. And Taguchi, he knows it.
Wow.
I can't believe that he didn't get the three count.
He calls out the Dodon. Put away some of the best in New Japan. With that has Taguchi, but it was not enough to put away Takahashi here. Takahashi is out on his feet though.
He's going for it again.
And Takahashi's going to try and counter into the ankle lock. Ankle lock, ankle lock from Taguchi again. This time Takahashi unable to scramble.
Too far away from those ropes. He has to tap.
Listen to the agony, the screams, the anguish coming from the mouth of Takahashi.
That ankle could be already broken. We don't know the condition it's in. Look at this. Clawing his way to the ropes.
Taguchi drags him back, going to try once again. Oh, this time he got him. He got him again. This time the Dodon's thrown. The cover, that must do it. Surely, no!
Wow. Just shows you how much both these men want to advance. The Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals mean so much. Not only are they representing their own careers, they're representing their proud heritage in Japanese wrestling. Which man will have that opportunity? Taguchi or Takahashi?
Well, I said it at the start, I'll say it now. I think that extra rest time has come in handy here for Taguchi, because he is the one, as we are entering the what presumably will be the latter stages of this match, he is the one who has the more energy left. Or does he? Oh, roll through, victory roll from Takahashi, and Takahashi steals it! Takahashi steals it! Takahashi is going to the World Cup Finals!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner,
Hiromu Takahashi has defeated two men in one night to earn the right to represent Japan in the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Taguchi asking referee Joel Allen if that was indeed a count of three. Unfortunately for him, his journey is over. He's travelled all the way from his native Japan to Manchester to try and make his dreams come true. The Pro Wrestling World Cup is out of your grasp, Taguchi. Takahashi still in with a shot. He is the first from Japan to advance to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals. August can't come soon enough.
Well, Takahashi's demanding his cat back. As you said, maybe the source of his power.
It seems to be. There's something going on there. I mean, I like cats as much as the next guy, but certainly not as much, or apparently not as much, as Takahashi.
Takahashi, whatever his eccentricities, has proven here in Manchester in not one but two incredible matches that he is world class.
Takahashi could be a very interesting pick to win this whole thing and to bring the Pro Wrestling World Cup home for Japan.
Well, would you bet against him? Now, as you see, eccentricities, he may have his quirks, but he's successful. He has won not one, but two matches here this evening, and he goes on to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals, and I can't wait to see what he has next in night.
Our second round matches here in the Japanese qualifier sees Kushida take on Bushi, a match that is very hard to call.
It's very interesting too, because you have the suspect, questionable tactics of Bushi going up against best of the Super Juniors in Kushida. What's going to give? Someone is going through to those Pro Wrestling World Cup finals.
The best of the Super Juniors. Is he about to prove that Japan is the best wrestling nation on earth by representing them in the World Cup final?
Said it. This is a match that I've been looking forward to seeing because we first saw Bushi earlier on tonight. Kushida's no slouch, but this man, Bushi, will do anything it takes to advance. Manchester has already decided they do not like this man.
Bushi with an incredible match against Tiger Mask in the first round, but it has to be said, Bushi took a shortcut to win that. Kushida needing no such shortcut. And Bushi, I assume, will take whatever measures necessary, even if it involves breaking the rules, to do the same to Kushida that he did to Tiger Mask.
But there's no doubt about it. The match between Bushi and Tiger Mask, it wasn't the match that anyone here in Manchester in the Pro Wrestling World Cup Japanese qualifiers were expecting. But that does not change the fact that Bushi, the masked menace, is only one victory away from representing his country in the Pro Wrestling World Cup finals. Kushida, he may be one of the best wrestlers on the planet. Those belts say he is. His tournament wins also prove that. He's the only man who can stop Bushi from doing that and advancing to the finals.
These two men know each other very well. They have competed no less than 12 times in the past in singles action, and it could hardly be any more evenly split. 6 wins for Kushida, 5 wins for Bushi, and a draw back in July 2007 between these two.
Well, we can't have a draw tonight. We cannot have a draw tonight. Surely, one of these men must advance to the finals.
It's worth saying, I said this earlier, it's worth saying again, until Linsky got pushed into the way, drop kick from Bushi.
More underhanded tactics from Bushi, but they're successful.
these two exchanging blows. Kushida getting the better of that, or at least he was until a thumb in the eye, I think that was. And Kushida not afraid to reply in kind.
Giving Bushi some of his own medicine right there.
Kushida to the ropes, leapfrog from Bushi. Kushida will roll through, Bushi to the ropes a second time. It's a Hurricane Rana, handstand to counter it from Kushida. Kushida lures him in, arm drag.
Little showmanship there from Kushida. Bushi won't like that.
Kushida, the current five-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. Hang on a second. Ooh. Right on the elbow. I was going to say, among those... Oh, hang on. Standing moonsault right on the head of Bushi. Goes for a cover and gets two. Among those 12 matches that these two have had in the past were matches for that IWGP Junior Heavyweight title. In fact, Bushi won it from Kushida and lost it back to him. Choke there from Bushi. Bushi, what's this? Bushi. That DDT snapping the neck of Kushida. Did right on the that? Ring apron.
Kushida, a real threat to his health right there. Bushi laughing. This is what he wanted all along. This man will advance by any means necessary. We've already... Oh, he's got
using
that cable.
Using one of our camera cables to choke out Kushida. He's still doing it. Referee's gone past the count of five. Obviously, we don't want a disqualification here, but Lindsay's got to step in.
You do not want to lose by DQ, disqualification. You do not want to have your dreams of going to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals obliterated because you got disqualified. But referee Steve Linsky, senior official Steve Linsky, he can only be pushed so far.
Well, this is a dilemma for Linsky because he doesn't want to be pushed around, but equally he doesn't want to end this by disqualification. Oh, God. Kushida face first into our announce table at the hands of Bushi.
This man, Bushi, is a dangerous, dangerous man. He will do anything it takes.
Got a smile on his face, so pleased with his handiwork there, inflicting pain on the current reigning best of the Super Juniors.
Right into our announce table here, Dave Bradshaw. And look at this, though. Back in the ring, where Bushi wants to win it.
Ripping at the face, and now he's got those legs wrapped around the throat, the head of Kushida, trying to wear him down. Kushida trying to counter this.
Oh,
and he finally gets his foot into the ropes. Will he break up before five this time? Yes, he does.
Well, that's surprising. But he knows what's at stake here. The count of five and he's out of here. He's not going to those finals. Kushida would go through by disqualification. Again, you can't let that happen.
It's a power struggle here between Bushi and the referee. Bushi trying to see just how far he can push Linsky without getting disqualified. Kushida turns around, drop kick from Bushi.
Look at that athleticism though. Right back to his feet. That was almost superhuman.
And this athleticism, it was showmanship from Bushi, who is growing in confidence by the second here.
Kushida with those strikes. He's not getting his full weight behind him, but he got his full weight behind that chop.
Again, much like we talked about in the previous second round match, don't forget, Bushi has had longer to recover than Kushida had. Kushida was the last of those first round matches. Into the STF here from Bushi. Saw this earlier on.
Well, this man, Kushida, he did not become
the
best of the Super Juniors by worrying about how much time he has between matches.
Raking
he
at the nose,
is such a phenomenal athlete, but again, as you say, that nose. If he breaks that nose, the blood will start to pour out. He won't be able to know where he is. He might not even be able to see. The pain will be that blinding. Bushi is counting on that.
There's an element of Bushi, you know, it's like a vicious like street fighter. He doesn't mind putting a thumb in the eye. He'll rake at your nose. He'll put his fingers in your mouth if he can help choke you that way. He'll do whatever he has to.
Kushida struggling to breathe here.
Kushida with the elbow into the jaw. Tries to go to the middle turnbuckle but didn't fight Bushi off sufficiently. Bushi now has got him in a very compromising position here on the second turnbuckle. It is precarious for both men. Both of these second rounders in the Japanese qualifiers. Only one of them can go on to represent their country in the World Cup finals.
Takahashi's already there.
Look at that! The arm lock! The arm lock! Can't get the submission on the ropes! Kushida! The arm breaker from the top! Very novel offense. That is one way to escape a perilous predicament for Kushida.
But you can still see that Kushida down on the mat, just like his opponent, he needed that offense to even give himself a chance of getting back into this match.
Kushida will take a run up at Bushi. Bushi moves out of the way, tries for the overhead kick. Kushida saw it coming, and Kushida drop kicking the side of the head. And you know, I think the other side of Bushi's head may have hit the ring post.
It could have. It could very well have struck that ring post. And if it did, he may be out for the count.
Well, Kushida has set up a chair here. Two chairs, in fact. We've moved one chair out of the way. He's put one up in position on the other side of the ring. What's he doing here, Kushida?
Clearly irritated and annoyed by Bushi's tactics. He wants to take the fight to him, but they better watch because senior official Steve Linsky.
Well, he's invited Bushi to take a seat quite forcefully. Kushida's going to take a run up. Kushida dropping off the chair on Bushi.
Both of those feet right to Bushi's chest. It knocked him for six right back into the safety barrier there.
Both men down now. Kushida obviously first to his feet after Bushi taking the impact of that drop kick off the chair.
Referee being very lenient here. They're back in the ring.
Kushida.
It's where they need to settle it, Dave Bradshaw.
Kushida's rolled him back in. Bushi didn't get in of his own volition. Kushida is dictating the pace here, or at least he was. And he still is. Still is. Kimura. Kimura into the armbar. Trying for the armbar. Trying to break the grip. Hyperextending the elbow of Bushi. Bushi trying to roll through. Shoulders down. Shoulders down. A two count. That was the only way that Bushi could escape.
Smart strategy, though, to reverse that submission. Oh, that was surely a few teeth that came flying out of Kushida's head. By fires back, and this crowd appreciating what they're seeing from both these men.
What a remarkable night of action it has been here in these qualifiers, the Japanese qualifiers for the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
It's been an education for James R. Kennedy, Dave Bradshaw, let me assure you of that. These men are awesome.
Kushida bringing Bushi to his feet. There's an arm breaker. That's the shoulder blade of him, of Kushida. A roundhouse kick misses. Kushida sent into the referee, put the brakes on. Oh, green miss! Green miss from Bushi into the eyes of our referee, Steve Linsky. And Kushida accidentally hit Linsky. Bushi moved out of the way. Linsky doesn't know who hit him. Linsky doesn't know anything at the moment. I think Linsky's unconscious.
I think the searing pain in his eyes may be taking up all his energy right now. All his focus. Look at this, Bushi has caught Kushida's leg.
Oh, a low blow, he did that earlier. He did that earlier to Tiger Mask.
Small package.
No referee, there's no referee. Well, Kushida is all tied up, but he can count to 100. If there's no referee, it doesn't matter.
Nobody can be angry at Steve Linsky though. That green mist must have been so damn painful.
Yeah, I don't know why Bushi's angry. If he didn't bring the illegal green mist into the situation in the first place, he wouldn't have been without a referee to make the count, would he?
He's almost lucky that he hit Steve Linsky. Not Kushida, but look at this from Kushida.
Again into that arm lock. Tap out, tap out, tap out. No one there, though. No referee there. Kushida doesn't care. He'll break the arm. Kushida will break the arm of Bushi if he can.
Both of these men would have won this match fair and square had referee Steve Linsky not been hit with that green mist.
Oh, this is dangerous. This is dangerous. Finally, Kushida over the top here. And he's still got that... still got that Kimura lock locked in. Wrenching backwards. Screams of pain from Bushi.
Well, he's already tapped out. We don't know if that arm has been dislocated, broken, whatever's going on in there.
Well, we're still without a referee, if anyone can hear us. I don't know what... I think Steve Linsky is still knocked unconscious.
We need to get another official down here right now.
Kushida! Oh! Three and net breaker. Both men down now.
They're completely spent. Both these men are completely spent. What a night this has been.
Kushida and Bushi, both men down. Our referee down as well. It is anarchy here in this second round match in the Japanese qualifiers.
This crowd don't know what's going to happen next, and I'm right there with them.
Kushida, by the way, was trained by Tajiri, ironically. It was Bushi who used the green mist, a trademark of the great Tajiri. And Bushi now being invited to deliver some strikes by Kushida, who has proven that he has more left, I think, than Bushi at this point.
Well, there's still no referee out here, but both these warriors, they will keep fighting until they get some kind of resolution. They're too deep into it now. I can't believe that we saw Bushi tap out. But Bushi also had Kushida beaten as well. That unbelievable
slap,
stuff.
Slap from Bushi may have knocked Kushida out. Such was the force. Yeah, look, Kushida is barely moving. He's dead weight now.
Bushi wants that referee back in there.
Well, he shouldn't have used the green mist then, should he?
You go and tell him that.
I don't speak Japanese. Kushida is attempting to be picked up by Ibushi here, by Bushi, I should say.
Kushida is out on his feet here. Bushi needs to put him away quickly here. Referee or not, he needs to hit something big.
A Canadian Destroyer! Wow.
He's got Bushi him again.
He's going for the cover.
Up to a five count now.
Well, there's still no referee.
Bushi is furious with this. Yeah. Furious with WhatCulture Pro Wrestling for not sending another official out here.
But we, I mean, at some point, if Linsky can't continue, we are going to need a referee.
The referee, in fairness to Linsky, has been blinded here. Please. No one can blame him.
Green substance all across the face of Linsky. I don't know if Linsky can see. How can he count a free count if he can't even see? Bushi! Oh! Kushida counted! Kushida countered!
Could have broken his jaw. Kushida with a second wind.
Oh, wow. Took a punt into the head of Bushi. Turns it around.
He's got that arm again.
Again into that lock. The Kimura lock. He calls it the hoverboard lock. The hoverboard lock. The Kimura.
He may ride that hoverboard all the way to the Pro Wrestling World Cup Finals.
Bushi trying to get to the ropes. He can't get there. Kushida with his body weight sat on the head of Bushi.
He tapped.
Kushida's the winner. Kushida goes to the World Cup Finals. What an effort.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Kushida.
Big win for Kushida. In a year that he has made his own, he may yet do even more. Kushida will represent Japan, one of two Japanese men in the last 16 of the Pro Wrestling World Cup.
Well, both those men deserve to be there, you have to say that. Great effort from Bushi, green mist or not, but in the end, the best of the Super Juniors. Could he be the best in the world?
Kushida advances alongside Takahashi. Takahashi and Kushida, the Japanese representatives in the Pro Wrestling World Cup! Japanese representatives in the Pro Wrestling World Cup, but our night in Manchester is not over. An international challenge match. I say a match. This will be a war.
WAR, war. Rampage. He's been waiting for an opportunity like this his entire life. Tonight in Manchester, he gets it. What a way to cap off an incredible night of action.
Ladies and gentlemen, The following match is scheduled for one fall and is tonight's main event. Making his way to the ring, hailing from Leeds, weighing in at 266 pounds, he's the Jushin, he has the opportunity of the border, Rampage!
Rampage, a part of WCPW from the very beginning. He's also been a part of some of the rest of the best wrestling promotions in the United Kingdom and beyond. He's a former Progress champion, former Progress Atlas champion as well, a two-time NGW champion, two-time TCW champion. I could go on and on. The point is that Rampage is arguably the best heavyweight that Britain has to offer, and he is going to have to prove just how good Britain is against one of the toughest men that Japan has ever known.
Well, I have stared this man in the eye. He has chased me, and let me tell you, he is a fearsome beast. Rampage has fought for every championship you can imagine, including the WCPW title itself. Tonight is about something different, something traditional for Rampage. And here we go, Bradshaw. The moment all these Mancunians and people watching across the world have been waiting for.
They call him the Stone Pitbull. And if you've never seen Tomohiro Ishii before, you are about to understand exactly why that nickname is so apt. God, this is going to be good. This is going to be something.
You said it best. A complete, all-out, total war.
Making us wait here, or more specifically, making Rampage wait. Some mind games from the 20-year veteran, and here he is.
Listen to that response.
Making his way to the ring, hailing from Tokyo, weighing in at 100 kilograms, Tokyo Sushi Yakukiro, the star.
Enormous ovation from this Manchester crowd for the Stone Pitbull, Tomohiro Ishii.
He certainly looks like he's carved out of stone, but across the ring from him is one of the UK's finest. And let me tell you, Rampage, you can see it right now. He has intent in his eyes. This is the moment he has been waiting for. Can he seize the opportunity?
Ishii been battling through the ranks of New Japan Pro Wrestling for many, many years, finally broke through in January 2014, when he beat Tetsuya Naito for the never open weight title. Since then, he has become a four-time holder of that title.
Oh, it's going to take more than that to take Rampage off his feet. Are we going to go vice versa? I think we are.
Yeah, Rampage is going to try again.
Both these men, like mountains.
Rampage, double shoulder block, neither man going down. And we could be here a while.
Rampage may have the height advantage in this one, but strength is anyone's guess.
Ishii to the ropes, Rampage sent back to the rope.
Ishii finally the first man down.
That's significant. That's hugely significant for Rampage, and he knows it.
Someone, for the most normal people, I couldn't think of a worse way to spend an evening than having to go head-to-head in a wrestling ring with Ishii or with Rampage. But for these two, this is exactly the kind of hard-hitting contest that they live for.
You're absolutely right. They live for this. They dream about it. They train for it. And look at those chops.
Ishii with the chop again.
Listen here, come on Rampage, he wants some back.
Look at this from Rampage, and the roar of defiance from Ishii.
Man, I'm almost stunned into silence by this. One of these strikes would take me out of commission for good.
Rampage, again though, has taken Ishii off his feet.
Any normal man, after just one of those forearms, one of those shoulder barges. They wouldn't be coming back from that, but both these guys are not ordinary human beings.
Short on clothesline from Rampage. Backs Ishii back into the ring post. Second time. Already this one really hard hitting, and that could be, you said about the significance of Ishii being knocked off his feet. What about that for Rampage? That could damage the left arm. If it does, then that is a major part of Rampage's offensive repertoire neutralized.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's a game changer, him hitting his arm right off Rampage, smacking the steel. And look at this now. They're taking it. They're taking it into the people.
Well, we're into the crowd here. Not sure. Huge chops from Ishii. Rampage fighting back with his own. Our cameras are trying to follow this.
I don't think anyone wants to follow these two men. You don't want to get in harm's way with Rampage and Ishii.
Well, our fans are absolute chaos here. We
apologise. They're coming back round this way, Dave Bradshaw.
We're trying our best to... He's throwing Rampage into the chairs with Ishii. From what we can see, it is hard to keep up with this. All around the building here. Big chop. Rampage fights back with a forearm.
You imagine the pain both these men are already going through.
Now they are coming back round towards our side of the ring here. Oh, Ishii with a chair into the abdomen of Rampage. Ishii is...
They're coming back over this way.
They are back there right in front of us here. That's making me nervous.
Absolutely. I don't feel safe one bit.
Rampage is getting over the barrier as well now.
Rampage coming back over.
I think he maybe had the worst of that exchange in the crowd with Ishii.
Well, that just threatened to spill over, didn't it? Wow. Hopefully that's the last we've seen of that.
And Ishii is
pure warfare. This is what pro wrestling is all about, Dave Bradshaw.
Well, I'm glad I'm a commentator, not a wrestler. This is unreal. The weight with which they are striking each other here.
He's straight to something else.
This is... It's like... Our Japanese referee here is giving a traditional Japanese 20 count for these guys to get back in the ring rather than a 10 count. Taiga Itori is our referee. One of the most experienced referees in the world. Look at this. Look at this between these two, it's unreal.
Oh, and both men realize the legendary official himself, Itori, was nearly up to the traditional 20 count. And we don't want this match to end by a double count out, Bradshaw.
Well, it's a good job Rampage knew the Japanese for 19. Ishii though is still...
I'd be surprised if Rampage can speak English after this match, the amount of abuse he's taking.
Yeah, Ishii is definitely the upper hand here, narrowly, but it is pronounced here, you can see it. Ever since they came back from the crowd, Ishii has been on top, got Rampage back in that corner.
Size does not matter when Rampage is down like he is right now. Ishii has it. Oh, wait a minute, Rampage fighting back now.
Ishii.
Man, these blows. Flesh, smacking flesh.
How do I, like Rampage especially, but Ishii as well, how do they have that left in the tank to hit each other with that much force this far into a hard-hitting heavyweight match?
Absolutely amazing athletes, both these men. Now, I knew Rampage was, but this Japanese warrior who has come over here to Manchester, he wants to prove a point and dominate one of the UK's best.
A nonchalance here from Ishii. Slap across the face. Well, that is obviously aimed at riling Rampage, and it may work. Do not poke the beast.
Oh, slapping him back. Look at that chop right across the throat of Rampage there.
And it's very rare to see Rampage gasping for air in the way he is after that.
He's getting back up though. Let's give him some credit. He wants some more.
Yeah, Rampage has fought some of the best in the world, but I don't think even he has been hit very often as hard as he's being hit here.
Ishii He almost looks surprised, or maybe not, by Rampage and his resilience.
Ishii with a headbutt.
It's almost like these men revel in this punishment. It's scary for human beings, normal, mere mortal men like us, to sit and watch this.
Oh god, side suplex from Ishii. Goes for the cover. Got that big right leg hooked, but good for two, only two so far.
Well, both these men have trained exclusively for this match, and we're seeing that right now. Ishii wants to cut Rampage down to size. Rampage with so much to prove, fighting back.
She's just screaming in the face of Rampage. He was a minute ago. Rampage scoops him up, slams him down.
He's looking for inspiration from his fellow countrymen here in Manchester.
Well, there is some support for Rampage, clearly, because he is the English guy in the match. But don't forget, a lot of these fans came here to see some of the best from Japan, so there's a lot of respect for Ishii as well.
No doubt, no doubt. And did you see how Rampage came off that corner turnbuckle there, flying through the air? You imagine a man his size, coming at you through the air and connecting. Man, it'd be like getting hit by a train.
Forearms now from Ishii. And again. But actually, suddenly it seems like Rampage is becoming almost not immune to them, but he is enduring them a lot better than he was before. Look at that roar of defiance from Rampage. Ishii grabs the arm, but Rampage turns it into a clothesline for the cover at 2.5. A not very convincing left shoulder up there from Ishii.
Well, he's been hit by some big men. I'm very sure of that. But has he been hit by anyone like Rampage? The strength of this man is incredible.
Oh, this was billed as one of the hardest hitters from Japan against one of the hardest hitters from the UK, and it is proving to be all that and more. Rampage! Jump across the chest of Ishii.
Almost caved his chest right in. And he's collapsed here. The full pain of that must be felt for a very long time.
You know, Ishii may be in trouble. He's being brought to his feet, but you're right. He did kind of crumple to the mat after that chop from Rampage.
He's really, really, really struggling to get his wind here. This is a smart strategy.
Look
good,
at this.
Good tactics from Rampage.
Ishii's headbutting the canvas to psych himself up and to find some of those reserves.
The more and more you hit this man, the stronger and stronger he seems to get. I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Unbelievable.
Another roar.
Incredible stuff from Rampage and Ishii. Rampage the boot. Ishii did not budge. He did not budge.
Primal rage.
Again and again, he does not budge. Rampage goes down from the forearm.
And now Rampage is rattled. He's grabbing those ropes after that amazing forearm. Wow, I'm stunned by what I'm seeing.
Ishii sends it to the corner. Clothesline snaps the neck of Rampage backwards. Reversal of the Irish whip from Rampage into the corner. Ishii comes flying out. Explosive stuff from Tomohiro Ishii. Goodness me.
Ishii's still in pain. He's shaking it off though.
Just like shrugging it off as if it was nothing. These guys are just beyond human.
Big I don't think suplex. I've ever seen.
Oh my! Rampage straight back to his feet.
I've never seen Rampage suplexed that way. And look at this. I'm sure Ishii has never been suplexed that way either. But he's back on his feet now too.
It is as much mental as it is physical between these two now. Neither man prepared to show any weakness in front of the other.
Both have went up a gear here. Both have went up a notch. This is alpha male stuff.
Another suplex on Rampage.
Did you see the ring canvas? It almost gave way.
Yeah, this time Rampage doesn't get up, but neither does Ishii.
I don't often agree with the people of Manchester, Dave Bradshaw, but tonight is one of the nights where I certainly do. This is awesome.
Ishii is first back to his feet. Lining up. Rampage here.
What's he going for now?
Big clothesline, and oh my. Rampage just shakes his head.
Oh, that one rattled him though.
Yeah, no hiding that one.
He can't soak up a third one, surely.
Uranagi! Uranagi slam from Rampage! The cover! Can Rampage beat one of the best in the world here? He was a split second away from doing so.
One of Rampage's trademark moves right there, the Uranagi. It almost got the job done, but not quite. The Stone Pitbull still very much in here. He's in with a shot.
Yeah, Ishii's been rocked though, he's been rocked. Rampage trying for the fireman's carry. Ishii fights back with a forearm to the face. Ishii goes to the ropes, gets called up. Samoan drop from Rampage. Rampage will go for the cover. Leg hurt. He may get it hit, did he? No.
Oh, that was close. That was very, very close. Probably too close for comfort for Ishii.
Again, this it was a kick out, but it was another unconvincing one from Ishii. Just narrowly got that right shoulder off the mat by an inch or two.
Rampage looking to be a stone breaker here in Manchester.
Oh, Ishii blocks the clothesline, headbutt into the face of Rampage. Rampage went for a clothesline. Here's a German suplex from Ishii.
He's back on his feet though.
Big lariat from Rampage. Both men down. Rampage didn't have enough in him to make the cover, and Ishii, to his credit, rolled onto his front so he couldn't be pinned.
Rampage nearly fell on his man there, and if he had, this match may be over. But you're right, Ishii just managed to get out of harm's way at the last possible second. We have a count on our hands here.
Referee is 2-6. Seven. Ishii is using the ropes to pull himself up here.
He's back up onto a solid base.
He is up on the count of nine. We are back underway. Rampage has got back to his feet. Both men a little unsteady, as you might expect.
Wailing away each other.
Ishii into the corner again. The ring moved a couple of inches there. Rampage, a primal roar as he charges at Ishii. Forearms, left, right, left, right. Rampage hits him back. Kick to the side of the head from Ishii. He'll go to the ropes. Rampage will pick him up, and a big spine buster from Rampage to finish it here. Will he? No!
One of the best spine busters in the industry, and it very nearly paid dividends for Rampage, but not quite. Not quite, and that's key. Ishii is still very much in this one. I can't believe I'm even saying that after the punishment these guys are taking.
How is either man still in this one?
Can both these guys be winners? Unfortunately not, but they certainly deserve to be.
Well, Rampage may try and end it here with the pile driver. Rampage, pile driver. Ishii countered it, he's trying to at least. Rampage is holding on. A backdrop attempt again is just a pure battle of wills here between Rampage and Ishii, and Ishii gets the backdrop finally. Such determination from both men. Boot countered, headbutt.
Oh, and Rampage down. That took everything he had out of him.
Ishii, the ropes, there's a big clothesline. He thinks that might have done it. He goes for the pin.
He changed plans out of authority there, though, Bradshaw.
Well, I think Ishii changed plans because I don't think he was going to go for the cover. Then he saw how hard he managed to hit that clothesline. And chose to try and grab the opportunity. Brainbuster. Cover from Ishii. Will that do it? And it does. Ishii victorious. What a battle. We promised you a war, and that is exactly what you got.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Ishii.
Vertical drop brainbuster, enough to give Ishii the victory over Rampage. But Rampage have absolutely nothing to be ashamed of. What a war between those two. Ishii walks away, no love lost apparently between these two.
Ishii victorious for James R. Kennedy's is Dave Bradshaw saying goodbye from the Japanese qualifiers for the Pro Wrestling World Cup.